Welcome to the Roma Theatre Retrospective 2020, produced by the Independent Theatre Hungary for the HowlRound Theatre Common. Although Roma are the largest ethnic minority in Europe, they still experience high level of racism and have to deal with many societal issues. Additionally, Roma are being represented in a very stereotypical way in the media and art world. The Roma Theatre has more than a century-long past with active professional theatre groups in many European countries, but unfortunately, they are still hardly known. The Roma Heroes Theatre Festival, initiated by the Independent Theatre Hungary, is the only international Roma theatre in country in the world, which have been organized in every year since 2017. Some of the present artists and their work are introduced in our series. And today, my guest is Mihaela Dragan, the writer and the performer of the play called Del Duma. Hi, Mihaela, how are you?
Hello, Judith. I'm fine, thank you.
Thank you for giving your time for this interview.
Sure.
Sorry. Could you please summarize very briefly what the play is about, how the idea came, what inspired you when you were rewriting it?
Yes, so Del Duma, Tell Them About Me is the complete title. It is the first theater play that I wrote. It was written in 2013, and it's about is discussing the topic of early marriage in Roma, within the Roma communities, and is a documentary theater play. I interviewed the Roma women that were experiencing like early marriage in the community, but I also wanted to give more context to the topic, so I've been starting from my own story, fictionalized of course, but a little bit fictionalized, because if you remember when I had the show in Budapest, that the Duma starts with my story as a Roma woman, that I didn't grow up in a Roma theater, in a Roma traditional community. It's like we are not an homogeneous group as Roma people, even if early marriage is one of the biggest cliche about Roma. I just wanted to put this topic in the context and say that I'm a Roma woman who grew up in a very modern way. And even if it happened like that, I also had to confront a lot of misogynistic experiences within the majority and Gage and with the white people. So early marriage is not a topic that we'll find it only in Roma community. It's something that is happening worldwide, and it's something that we should discuss more generally as a society. Yes, so it's like Del Duma is saying the stories of four Roma women, very differently stories, with their experiences with marriage and with relationships with men in general. And it's talking about, as a Roma feminist, I also had to position it regarding this topic. And this early marriage was one of the biggest fasts that I had somehow in my life as a feminist, let's say. And also it preoccupied me a lot in my art to talk about it.
Thank you.
Yes.
Do you have a favorite part in the play? I don't know, that you really like, or that it was, or because it was challenging for you, or because it's very close to you, as also as a performer, as a writer.
Yes, because I took interviews for Roma women. I think the closest, part for me, it's the fourth story, the last story of Roxana character, that was inspired from the story of a real girl that had to baptize in order not to get married. And for me, she was as a heroine. I remember when I met her that I was overwhelmed by all her personality and her fight against early marriage. So if you will see the show, then you'll notice her presence at the end of the show. And I think it's one of the parts of the play where I feel really attached by this character, especially because she's a real person.
I would also be interested in what motivated you or who inspired you during your life and also in your career, but also more about in your life that you chose art and that you chose theater, how this whole direction came into your life.
I'm coming from a Roma musician's family, so my whole life I was raised among artists. So I remember that since I was a child, I wanted to be an actress. So I'm really the the cliche dream of how to become an actress. And it's everything that I wanted to do in my life, I told you, since I was a little girl. And my musician's family was an inspiration for me for this play. But I also have to mention that being Roma wasn't always a reason of pride, especially when you grew up and you confront all the prejudices. So I think it was a time in my high school when I tried to hide my Roma identity. And when I went to the university, I rediscovered it in a very beautiful way, that I understood that it's not any problem with my Roma identity, that it's a lot of stigma. And this is why I wanted to use theater, what I know to do, in order to bring awareness to the people. So I think the moment in which I started to work and research this topic was that moment when I also redefined myself as a Roma person, and instead of hiding or being ashamed of this identity, I took a lot of pride from it, and this was my reason to write the play.
And also, who inspired you, or who were the people during your life who gave you, motivation or supported you?
Yeah, I think even if I'm coming from a Roma family, the women that surrounded me, like my grandmother, my mother, my aunt, I took a lot of inspiration from them. And I'm grateful that I grew up in this family where women had a voice and men respected their voices. So definitely they were an inspiration for me. And afterwards, when I had this moment of fulfilling my identity with pride, I also met a lot of Roma women that inspire me a lot, and they continue to inspire me. So everything I am writing or performing is starting from this kind of inspiration.
Thank you. And could you please also share a few sentences about your artwork? What are your principles in your artwork when you perform or when you write an art play or a piece?
Yeah. Now when I'm looking back at the moment when I started to write to this play, to Del Duma, I think I was more moderate, and my discourse were more moderate. And with all these years, I became more radical. And radical is not something wrong at all. It's like radical in the sense that I want the rights for us now. Like, I think I put ourselves and the women fights on the first place now. So it's funny sometimes when I'm watching Del Duma, you know, that I just see myself like seven years ago, younger, and at the beginning of my career, and was the time when I also discovered so many things, when I received a lot of anti-racist and feminist knowledge. So this is why this play will be always important for me, because like was the first time when I tried to apply this practice in my artwork. And my goal was to give space for all these women that I interviewed. But at the end, after I wrote the play, I just figured out that I have also to put myself in a vulnerable position somehow, and sharing my intimate story as a Roma woman. So yeah, this became since then an art practice for me, then, to give space for other voices, because I always repeat that I'm a privileged Roma woman. I'm not coming from a community. I don't confront the situations that they are facing. So to give space to other voices was one of the principles. And even if we, the artists, we are always perceived to be egocentric and focused also only on our career and so on, this is not anymore about us. It's not anymore about me as an actress. It's not anymore about me as a playwright. It's about a real issue, early marriage, and it's about the fights of these powerful Roma women. And they have to be visible more than me and more than my artistic product.
Thank you. And also connected to what you said just now about feminism and theater, I would like to ask you, what does Roma theater and feminism mean to you? Like, do you consider it necessary for Roma theater makers to have their own institutions? Or what's your take on it, on this?
Yes, like having this experience in my group, like for more than 5 years, like working as independents, it was a difficult process to coagulate a company. It's a difficult process to access support, financial support, institutional support. And this is why we want to create the Roma State Theater, because we want to engage the authorities to our cause. Like, for example, in Romania, we have many minorities theaters, but not for Roma community. We are the only largest community in Romania who has no cultural institution, not a museum, not an art gallery, not a theater. And, you know, we exist, you know, like Roma artists, they were always here, you know, working. It's not only a hobby, it's our work, and it should be paid and remunerated as a work. So yeah, and we need an institution to represent us, definitely.
Thank you. My last question, it's a general one, but it's an important one. What's your future plan or goal regarding in your life and your career, also because of the pandemic now? What's the situation?
Yes, I have to say that I didn't suffer so much because I wasn't able to perform, to be on the stage. It wasn't something that I really missed. Because in the last years, together with my colleagues, we have been working as crazy, you know, and especially because we are freelancers. And when we are a freelancer, you always have the worry for tomorrow, what I will do tomorrow. So you have to take all the projects and to do so many things at the same time. And I have to say that I took a moment of rest, but at the same time, all this pause or this break gave me space to rethink about what I want to do in the future and how the world will look like in the future. So I imagine a lot of other digital projects. And for the moment, I'm focusing on writing and on video art. So this is these are my plans for the future.
Thank you very much. Do you have anything to add that you forgot to say, but you still think that it's important to mention?
Yes, maybe I will also like to insist on this thing that early marriage is not something that is definitory for Roma people and our communities. That is an issue that is happening the whole world. I know that I repeated this, but I sometimes, you know, for the white audiences, it's not so visible. This is why I'm insisting on this, because I don't want this issue to remain a cultural one. And I always try to avoid in my art it was a very difficult writing process, because it's difficult to criticize something that that is happening, you know, like the girls' rights, the women's rights in connection with marriage, but at the same time not to reinforce the stereotypes about Roma community as a whole, you know, because these women are coming from the communities and these women, they are Roma. But I repeat, you know, it's an issue that is happening everywhere in this world, and I just want people, you know, to look at these women as I looked at them, with a lot of inspiration, and they empowered me a lot, even if many of them they didn't even know the word feminism, you know, or that their fight is a feminist one. They are doing concretely feminist work in their communities, trying to change mentalities. So definitely they should be seen as heroines and women that are advancing human rights discourse in the society, in the whole society.
Thank you. Do you also have like a message that you would tell Roma girls and women, maybe?
Actually, yes, because today is the day of the girl internationally. I don't know when the interview and the play will be streamed on HowlRound, but today is the day of the internationally day of the girl. And actually, I wrote recently a new theater play that is focusing on girls, and is talking about the lack of sexual education and how this is reinforcing abuses. I was really looking the whole summer in the process of writing this play to put messages of empowering the girls. And it was a very beautiful process, because never I've been thinking about, you know, this critical age, you know, from 13 to 18, you know, how much we experience as girls, and I really want them to be safe in this world and to empower them. So my message for today will be like, girls, you are powerful, you are fighters, you are beautiful as you are, and you deserve a voice and a place for your voice. And don't forget that you are not alone. You are a whole, we are a whole community, and we can be here for you anytime when you want.
Thank you. I think it's a very nice note to end this this interview on. Thank you for the discussion, Mihaela, and then good luck with your plans and with your goals and with your future projects.
Thank you so much, Judith, for your smart questions. And I'm really glad that I had the opportunity to see you again. And thank you for everything, and I wish you the same. And hopefully we'll be able to see each other soon.
I hope the same. So now you can see the performance called Del Duma, performed and written by Mihaela Dragan. Enjoy the show.